Time to tee it up in the Mountain West. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Lawson is on the field to kick this one off. And everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line. Well, from that first time they walked on campus as a recruit to their freshman season, and now here they are as seniors taking the field for the final time. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Lundy's going to forget about all the distractions. That includes talking about winning awards. And talking to him, he seems like a pretty focused, driven guy, and I think he's all about team. From their own 28-yard line. Second down. He's pushed out of bounds at the 35. Kennedy picks up about 7 yards on the run. Complete. He's got room to work. And down he goes, right around the 46-yard line.
You feel bad to criticize anybody for being aggressive, but if he wouldn't have been on the play action, I don't know if they would have been able to pick up the first down.
They bring him down in the backfield.
He just timed the snap count there. It really made a nice play.
From their own 43-yard line, it's second down. And again on the backfield. He's knocked out of bounds. It's right around the 20. Well, Kirk, today we get to take a look at one of the top cornerbacks in the country, and you and I have been looking forward to this. Eaton's decision-making abilities make him very effective against any defense he's ever played with.
Well, defenses have to put pressure on him and not let him get comfortable.
If you allow him to stay in the field, he'll simply pick you apart.
If you can disrupt his rhythm, it'll give you a chance at least shutting him down.
That's right, for a nice game. Dukes has got the weight of the team on his shoulders right now after the way he performed last season, Kirk. And I'm telling you, the season he had a year ago, it really makes expectations go through the roof. From their own 25-yard line, second down.
Brad, this guy had a huge year last year, but look at him now. I think he even looks bigger than he did a year ago. Look for him to have a huge year.
Play fake. Going long. Green. the intended target, and that'll bring up a punting situation.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Lawson to punt. He gets out about the 48-yard line. Talk about laying the groundwork early as a defense. They come out and done their job, and that could set the tone for the whole game.
This is one of my favorite things about the job that you and I have, is going around the country and looking into these kind of environments and seeing how they can impact the college football game. And early in this game, this defense is just feeding off of this energy to this game.
And he's down to the 46-yard line. The stop at about the 31. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Gets out to about the 31. At the 19-yard line.
It's a smart job here by the coaches, making a play call here that really played to their offensive strengths. That's knowing your personnel.
Complete. It's the junior. Big play, and it's first and goal.
Rodriguez brings him down at the 7-yard line. That makes it first and goal.
From the 7-yard line. First down. And he is drilled at the one.
Nothing flashy at all. But now, that first down marker is a lot closer.
This is the ninth play of the current drive. Short yardage defense here. Touchdown. A short burst for the school.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
He makes the PAT. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
The Huskies and the Coons in the Apple Cup. This was a tight one to the very end. Washington State gets the victory, 24-16.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line. Makes it to the 22-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Makes it to the 31. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9.
That brings up second and 1.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and 1. And they hit him in the backfield.
Did you see how that big defensive line got such a good push on that play? That's exactly why they were able to stop him for a loss.
It's the tailback. Brought down around the 29-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. That brings us fourth and three. Kennedy back deep to return. Tackle at the 43-yard line. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown.
I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of this. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure, try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
Made at the 32-yard line.
I'm a little surprised that they ran the option using the fullback. But certainly made the most of his opportunity.
He's at the 20, inside the 10. Touchdown! Huge play!
Did he hold me, coach?
That gives him another touchdown to go along with the one he scored earlier.
This young man is no stranger to the end zone. That's two rushing scores for him on the day, and you have to love the way he's been running the ball all game.
And he tacks on the extra point. A four-play, 57-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. So our score, 14-0. McCoy gets set to kick this one away. Whitworth from the four. He's tackled at the 30.
I've got to think the offensive coordinator is not really that concerned.
Well, they're off to a slow start, but this is also part of just kind of getting an awareness and an understanding of what the defense is trying to do to your offense. Now you've got to make the adjustments, and then you go back and start calling plays that you think will be able to attack this defense and get points on the board.
The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball.
They've been soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
And we've reached the end of one. 14-0. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. He's scrambling. He's taken down around the 43-yard line.
No gain in the play. That makes it second and 10.
And he's taken down at the 45-yard line.
All gain is 2 yards. That makes it third and 7.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. Fires right side, got his tailman, and they push him out around the 50-yard line.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it fourth and 2.
He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. Goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
Lost tackle at the 19. They'll lose a yard on that quarterback keeper.
From their own 19-yard line, it's second down. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. That's a deep three on the play. That'll bring up third and eight.
Defense has to be very frustrated here. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. Somehow, he was able to throw the ball away.
McCoy is the punter.
He's got the corner. And down he goes
at the 43. Think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
He's leveled at the 25-yard line.
It's a great job here by the quarterback in recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
Got a first and 10, ball on the 25-yard line. He makes it to the 25-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
That'll bring up second and 11.
So it's third down, and they got about 2 yards to go. They bring it down for a loss on the play.
That is a loss of 2 yards. That makes it fourth and four.
It's up, and it's good.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20, and he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
Well, the way this thing started, I thought we were going to have a points from this offense, but things have really slowed down. Defense is doing a good job.
Yeah, the defense has done a much better job of slowing down the big playability. We'll find out if this offense can maybe refocus at halftime and try to get back to where they were early in this game.
Quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play.
He laterals the ball.
Gets to about the 24-yard line. Look out, loose ball. It's recovered. They'll knock him down for a loss. From their own 14-yard line, third down. Going deep, lays it out there. Missed him.
Can't ask for much more than a 3-and-out. Great job, defense.
Whitworth will be the return man.
Signals for a fair catch.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
Complete and taken down immediately. About 4 yards on that play.
He got just a little bit of separation from the defender, and that was enough room for him to make the catch.
From the 41-yard line, second down. They'll drop him for a loss. Ouch.
Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end or short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at the moment.
Deep ball, laying it out there. This one will fall incomplete.
They're really fortunate to still have a shot at points.
Wasn't one of the prettiest passes I've ever seen. He's got to be relieved it wasn't bent.
Try to change the field position with his kick. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback.
Big first half lead here, Herbie.
Well, they've done a nice job here in the first half, and they've been able to build up a big lead. But remember, it's a four-quarter game. Make the adjustments at halftime and continue to try to fight this defense to get more points.
Well, I'm sure the offense will be looking to avoid the turnover that ended their last game.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
He's pushed out of bounds at the 25.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 25-yard line. Fired back to his fullback, but he can't hang on. Throw caught by the fullback.
That's a deep six on the play. That makes it first and ten.
Scrambling around, and he's going to be set for a loss.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
It's second and 15. Ball on the 26. Throws it out there.
And it's going the other way.
He's out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
Right, this week, these coaches told us about how they want their players to fight and really be determined. Here they are down by a couple scores, and the defense comes up with a big interception, showing that character that their coach has wanted to get.
Got it, but he's going to lose yards here.
The offense calls a timeout,
and they've got two remaining. We've got a second and 11.
Ball on the 45-yard line.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled right around the 36-yard line.
The offense calls a timeout.
That was their second timeout.
Surge by the defense. They really disrupted the timing on that play and gave them no chance to get the first.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Do
Dukes takes it counter right. And they get nice yardage on that one. He heaves it to the end zone. As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. 14-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that it got. Chris Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Neither ground game got much going in the first half, averaging a little less than 3 yards per rush. David, as you look at this, you always hear the term, get the offense behind the chain. When you get them in long yardage situations, what does that do for you?
Well, it's so much fun. You start with the defensive line, you know it's a pass. You get to fly upfield as fast as you want to. It's not third and three when you're sitting in a situation where they could run or they could pass, and there's a little bit of doubt in your mind when you're coming. You fly upfield, you rush the passer. Everybody knows that the sticks are a little bit further back, so DBs can back up a little bit and play to the sticks, and as opposed to playing third and short situations. It makes it easier on the whole defense.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Caught at the 8. He makes it to the 25-yard line. You know, sometimes you see defenses play good in stretches. This has been the longest stretch I've seen one defense play in a football game in a long time.
Yeah, I think the consistency is the thing that stands out. I think they got off to a great start. At halftime, they made a few adjustments. They've come out and even played better, believe it or not, here in this second.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Now the receiver, and he dropped it. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Zips it to the tailback, incomplete. He looked like he just sort of aimed that one.
Yeah, he didn't look very natural throwing the football there, and the result was an underthrow.
Zips it to the back. Brought down at the 22. Taken back 3 yards.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That'll bring up fourth and 13.
Lawson is waiting for the snap. Tries to get around the corner. Kennedy at the 41. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. They're set to go for another round.
At about the 37-yard line.
They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
They'll bring him down at the 34. And he gains around 3 on that kicker.
He got right in there and popped the ball carrier. This senior just doesn't back down from any.
And they make the stop at the 11.
That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury.
Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 7-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown. He made a great move to get into the end zone.
There's a perfect play call. They look like they practiced that one a few times.
And he hits the PAT.
Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
Going on in Columbia. The Tigers strike through the air, getting into the end zone for a touchdown. Missouri in front, 14-7.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. Back to the action here. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Taken from the 10. He's out to the 30. He's knocked out of bounds at the 39. The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to put the ball away the last time they had it.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
He's at midfield. Makes it out to about the 43.
First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. Tackle made around the
41-yard line.
Smith on the tackle at the 41-yard line. That brings up second and 9.
Setback.
That's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped it well short of the line of scrimmage.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33.
Wants to go long and does. Keeps a foot in and pulls it down.
Down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air.
Throws it out right to the running back. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
That's a deep problem. That brings him second and 5.
Middle and he stopped.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handle.
That'll bring him 36.
And so it's another third down upcoming here. He gets rid of this one. Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights. Let's get the ladies now from Reese Davis.
We've been watching what's happening in Columbia. This one's been entertaining us all day long. And for Texas A&M, they're sleepwalking through this thing. They don't turn it around. They're going to get into a world of trouble. Deadline at the moment, tied at 14.
You can never look ahead a week, but that would be a pretty big upset if that school won. Looks like they're ready for the kick. From his own goal line, he's to the 20, across the 30, He gets hit
at about the 35. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Tries to pitch it, and now the ball is loose. Picked up by the defense. The 10, and he's brought down at the 6-yard line.
I tell you, when the option works, it can be beautiful to watch. But when it doesn't, it can go horribly wrong. Not a good result for the offense.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They try to run up the middle, but met in the backfield.
I thought they might have been able to exploit the over-pursuit of the defense, but not on that play.
Brings up second and goal. We've got second and goal. Ball on the 10-yard line. Dukes gets 6 yards on the board. That makes it 30-4. And the goal line defense digging in here.
Counter play. They're not done yet.
In this territory, but they look totally in control there.
He makes the PAT.
So a short three-play, 7-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
So the score now, 21-13. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the one. Brought down at the 30-yard line. Pickup returns 29 yards. So the offense comes out after their last drive. Had the ball end up in the defense's hands by way of a fumble.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
And they push him out at the 37.
The halfback option good for 7 yards. Pitches it. He's tackled at the 47.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
That brings up second and 13.
From their own 44-yard line, it's second down.
And he hits him hard with a 38-yard line.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Whitworth waiting the return. And he muffed it.
Well, that's exactly what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. Concentration for a return man is of the utmost importance.
Well, at least for now, the crisis was averted and they keep control of the ball.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
His tight end, and he's taken down at the 38. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Pass right, running back's got it. He's pushed out of bounds
at about the 33-yard line.
First down.
into the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. 21-13. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. And it's incomplete.
Thompson was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 43-yard line. Second down. And he just gets rid of it. Fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop, and now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. He's taken down at the 47-yard line.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
A conversion there could have really helped it, but it just wasn't to be. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
Gain of 10. That'll make it second and inches.
And he's tackled right around the 40.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. First down.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
That makes it 6-10.
Maybe the 39-yard line. Under pressure. Needed that play, and he dropped it. McCoy is the punter. Well, too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. This is really kind of shocking. You're talking about one of the top offenses in the country, and they can't get anything going today.
Well, they can't run the football. They can't throw. There just isn't any continuity there at all. You got to give credit to this defense for the way they've stepped up and stopped this powerful offense today.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. They give to the tailback. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
From their own 21-yard line. Second down. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Two on the play. That makes it 37.
Man, oh, what a hit. Robinson gains 4 yards on that reception.
That brings us 4-3.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. He dropped it. Over the corner. And down he goes at the 43. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. He fights forward to about the 43.
Yourself in a position having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. He rifles it. The stop
at the 25.
So what do you think of this receiver after that play?
The quarterback made a nice throw, but it was the receiver who made this happen. That's a great way to make a statement.
Caught with room to work.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes it second and two.
Just under three to go in regulation. Good open field tackle. The defense calls a timeout. And they've got two remaining. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Throws out, got it back again. Down, right around the 4-yard line. The defense calls a timeout. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Incomplete, trying to get to the receiver.
Boy, what a bonehead decision. That's a free timeout you just gave your opponent. You just gave it away. Poor decision making right there.
It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out. Just under two to go in the game. Throws quick to the receiver, and falls incomplete.
Johnson's intending to see the play. That brings him fourth and goal.
Kicks up, and it is good.
That was a crucial kick, and it very well could end up being the difference in the game.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Robinson fields it at the 2. He's tackled at the 25-yard line.
You know, we love being around this defensive coordinator. He had a plan, and boy, he executed it today.
Yeah, he shared that plan with us, and you wonder sometimes if the plan's going to be able to play out the way it has today. But everything is clicking, from the coaching to the playing and the execution. Just a dominant game.
It's a new possession for this offense, and what will it hold? At the 33, they pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
And he stops the clock with a spike. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
score, 37-yard line.
About 3 yards to pick up the first down. Under a minute left. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's tackled on the 46-yard line.
Have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive lineman. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. He's in trouble. Loose football. And the offense will recover. Points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. The defense calls a timeout, and now they've got no timeouts left. He takes a knee.